back the little plates that look like animals?
Yeah.
Well, how about it?
I got them as a kid because my mom hates me.
For this card, Amanda said he feels like we're entitled to Are you or a loved one entitled to compensation based on the ads that you had to watch as a child waking up at 3 in the morning?
Or the Magic Bullet infomercial, dude?
You mean stream ended? Can you not see me right now? I should still be live. Is anybody else having issues? Oh. Okay. I guess we got censored for talking about Zoo Pals. That's the only thing I can think. Had to be. Couldn't be anything other than that. Alright, I need to switch these. Because I want to gulp you.
Definitely not that. Oh no, it's not.
Alright, Clement. Not letting you die, bud. Well, I'm glad everybody's back.
It definitely wasn't talking about the commercial
scribble.
Yeah.
No, that wasn't it. Alright, well, you know what? I actually have to do Earth Tremor anyways to kill the Buzzy Beetle, because it's stupid like that. I'm telling you, my stream just became like a trauma center for people that were abused by 3 AM commercials and George Lopez. Yeah, I'm fine with that. I'm fine if this is the place that y'all need to find safety from those commercials and George Lopez. Shit, I fucked that up. Please hit the Buzzy Beetle.
What about those really religious CD compilations?
Damn it. Yeah, no, those were a thing too. All I have is Zest Tea and 2 Life Shrooms.
Yeah.
I just have to appeal till I can get enough to fucking do that again. I was about to say, he's mini-egged, so that's fine, because, like, he can't hit me right now. Yeah. Listen, Michael McDonald will always be stuck in your head in some faction. That's just how it is. I literally had that in my head all day during my last shift at the hospital because of you. That was exactly, I'm sitting there just, can't believe we're not in love anymore.
Well, that's not Michael McDonald,
okay? Fuck you.
I will cry so hard. No, George Lopez.
No, you won't. Fushigi, Jesus Christ.
Moon shoes.
Fucking moon shoes, bro?
Like, such fast words on stage.
Fushigi, moon shoes! Skip it!
Bob. I don't know why I'm doing Pirates of Trauma.
Yeah, that was it. In the arms of the angels, far away from me. Save dogs in trouble.
You stopped it. You tried so hard.
Famous died today? It has been a while. Let me see. You know what? You guys deserve that hard-hitting information.
Wait, I'll look at it. I got it.
Why are there ads again? There literally shouldn't be any ads. It has not been an hour. Oh, because fucking stream ended then came back. That is so stupid. Alright. Clement needs to sleep asleep. Today. Has to be today. We'll send Coops out. Hopefully there's no flying enemies. We're gonna pause the conversation for those of you that have an ad going right now, and we'll come back to it.
Okay, so
even within our lifetime. He is damn right. He is damn right. It was always like a random plush that had nothing to do with the association.
Okay. Can everybody hear me?
No, we're still in an ad break.
Good.
Didn't want the plush, but goddamn it, if they didn't sell that shit right, that's what I'm saying, right? Luigi, I have a story for you when you're back from the ad break. If you can hear me right now, do not. But say, please do not give me another fucking stupid ass poison mushroom thing.
Everybody, clap your hands when you're back. Whatever.
Okay, we level up. Perfect. So we're full healed again. That's awesome.
Really bad.
Nah, 26 seconds still.
Damn it.
I know. More foop. I'm gonna have dreams about all these commercials tonight. I just know it. It's gonna happen. You're gonna have a dream that you woke up on your couch 10 years ago, 15 years ago, and you're waking up on the couch to this commercials. Alright, ad break is officially over. Everybody's back. Sorry about that, guys, because stream ended and then came back, I guess they rolled an ad break, but I was like, we just had an ad break, like, 10 minutes ago, so I don't know what the fuck's happening. But because ad breaks are automated and I have no control over them, that's just what it is. Lisa has something she needs to say, but I need to catch up with chat again real quick. So Lisa, if you want to go first.
Yeah.
She found the celebrity death for today.
So just celebrities?
Famous. Anything famous.
Are you good, Lisa?
She can't right now. Can't do Wilmerding on camera right now.
Yep. Famous people. You're hot.
Alright, well, while she's looking that up...
I got it. Don't even worry about it. Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Yeah. Do I just pick one person, or...
Yes, pick any, literally any person.
Brian Travers, the British rock saxophonist for the band UB40, who did the song Red, Red Wine, died of cancer on August 22nd, 2021. Everybody listen to Red Red Wine tonight, among the other commercials.
And on top of that, I got a strange sack now, which is what we were all waiting for.
Yeah.
Okay, going back to this. Because I think the ad break started when Mikey typed, were you exposed to adult ads as a child with your parents' permission? You may be entitled to compensation. Call 1-800-SUE-THEM to join our class action lawsuit. Is overreacting ads. Yep, they were very much... There were so many overreacting ads back in the day.
Oh no! I spilled tomato sauce on my counter! And it could just wipe off real easily, but oh my god, what am I gonna do?
That kind of shit, yeah.
The answer I was gonna say would actually get you banned for a little bit.
Jesus Christ.
You can imagine what I was gonna say.
At least 1 million spotted lantern died today for sure. Yeah. Casually watching Cartoon Network or something like that in the middle of a commercial, these kinds of commercials just pop. Oh, they did all the time. They did all the damn time. They had like different kinds of Legos and Bionics and stuff like that that you could build. They knew the target audience that they were going for kids that would be like, ooh, I want this. I want this. Dad, buy this for me. Mom, buy this for me. And then you would get toys.
What about the weird Adult Swim like mini commercials?
God, the Adult Swim commercials were fucked. There's a couple of them that weren't commercials that were actually part of the TV shows. They were messed up. Have a beautiful t-shirt. Honestly, as a child, I was mad that wrestling had to change from WWF to WWE because the World Wildlife Federation. I didn't know that's why they had to change it. And yeah, Luigi, I was saying that's all they did. They took a gorilla that they bought from, like, a 50-cent store and then stamped something on it and then they put it in a t-shirt and that was it. And that's what I call music. Oh my god, we're on what? Now that's what I call music, like, 56? We're on some absolutely ridiculous number like that now. Compilation of all the 2000s ads. I got you, Panda. I'll literally do a stream where we'll just put them all together. We'll put them all together in one place and then get sued because they're all here in one place. Dreams, battles, commercials tonight. I was just going to say we're all going to have nightmares. Anyone remembering those ringtones? Yeah. And then better than the ringtones, the chip tones, right? The little tiny ones that were crushed in MIDI files. Like, it would be Blue by Eiffel 69? Eiffel whatever the hell the name of their band was, right? But it'd be like... It was not the song you wanted it to be. It was just that. And Mikey Redoomed, ding. He said, why are her arms broken? No, she just can't get on a camera right now. That's where we'll leave it. And you're back. Use $1 out of my $20 pay as you go minutes for a sweet-ass ringtone. And that's it. And then you got like a ringback tone too, so that when people called you on the phone, they could hear, look at this photograph. Every time I do it makes me laugh. Because that's, you know, what was cool. You just needed that. Nobody cares about it. 6 hours getting into level 93 of the pit just to lose. The last 10 floors are fucking brutal. Yes, they are. Bone tail, so it is what it is. Yeah, he is rough as shit too. I remember, well, at least in this game. At least in this game, we have a cheat where I can make a save state at floor 99 and we can be great. It'll be good. Get in the van. We're going to rough and bump. Jesus fucking Christ. We have to drink heavily for that. Good. Now if you type exclamation point RNB, it just says, get in the van, we're going to rough and bumble. It's on 86? What the fuck is that? Jesus Christ. Now that's what I call music, 86? That is insane. How did we get to that point? I remember when it was, now that's what I call music 12. I mean, granted, I was like, 8 at the time, but like, 86, dear Lord. Where are we getting this at? Where are we from? Luigi, if you're still here, I have a story for you about our honeymoon in particular. So speaking of Cartoon Network, and for anybody that doesn't know this story, by the way, that was it. I had to get to the strange sack so that I could, I now have 20 slots to fuck around with in here instead of 10.
They're on 87.
They're on 87 now? Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Oi, that is way too many now. That's what I call musics. Everyone had Hey Ya by Outkast was the last good one. That came up literally today in conversation with me and somebody else. Anyways, ADHD aside, trying to get my mind back straight here for a second. On our honeymoon, we went down to the Dominican Republic. Hello. Can we unfreeze, please? I'm literally mid-paper plane. Thank you. We were down at the Dominican Republic, and one of the restaurants that we went to required a dress code. No other restaurants did, this one did. So it required a dress code for men and not women. Lisa still got dressed up because it was our honeymoon, and we were having a very nice meal at a Brazilian steakhouse. And I was wearing a dark black button-down shirt with a collar, and my hair, it's kind of pushed down now. It was a little bit longer at the time, but it stands up. And it's blonde, right? So there I am, walking past this guy who's singing karaoke, one of the entertainers that they hire for the resorts. And he pulls Lisa up to sing karaoke, and she goes and sings karaoke with him real quick, and we're on our way to dinner. So then he looks over to me, and in 5 seconds does an up and down on my body, and goes, hey, Johnny Bravo, get over here. And I was just like, oh. Oh, I respect you so much. Because that was so good, and it came out of absolutely nowhere. I was like, dear Lord, I'm a big dude, a big muscly dude, and you looked at me for 5 seconds and thought of a cartoon character from the 90s. And that hits deep, because I know he just pulled that out of the back of his brain and threw it straight at me. And that was crazy. It blew my mind. Israel should have burned to the ground on this point. A Kids Bop is horrible. The lyrics that they do, my God, are they bad. So yeah, you saying Cartoon Network made me think of that story, and it was something else. I was absolutely blown away. I had nothing to say to this man when he said this to me because I just could not speak. He managed to floor me with one statement. Shit. God damn it. Johnny Bravo stream? You want me to dress up as Johnny Bravo and stream? God. I shouldn't have said anything. I would have to buy all the shit to cosplay as Johnny Bravo, so it's gonna take some time to set up, but I guess if that's what the people want. What's the one kid, like Matty B Raps or something? I have never heard of that. I have literally never heard of that, and I don't know if you're being sarcastic in saying that his version of Miss Jackson was amazing or not. I'm not sure. I guess I'll have to listen to it. But that... Is it really good or is it bad good? It'll change how you look at... That sounds like bad good. That sounds like very bad. Because no song, you know, from the past that was remade by a child should be able to change my view of music completely. You know, Mikey, you're not that wrong. You're not that wrong. It probably wouldn't take a lot to cosplay as Johnny Bravo now that I'm thinking about it. And I probably have a black t-shirt that I could wear, but at the same time, see, maybe that'll be a goal for when we do the subathon for playing Mario RPG. Guys, that's gonna be a thing, by the way. I don't know if I'm gonna do it here or on YouTube. I don't know what I wanna do with it yet. But I'm gonna have goals along the way. If we don't hit any of those goals, it is what it is. If we don't end up playing the whole game in one night, it is what it is. But when Super Mario RPG Legend of the Seven Swords comes out for the Nintendo Switch and I get it on day one, you better fucking believe we're gonna play the shit out of it. And I'm planning on doing a literal, like, as long as it takes stream. If you guys want me to play the whole damn game in one night, and we have a subathon, and the timer keeps going up and up and up and up, and I play the whole damn game in one night, that's just what it is. I can always go back and replay the game, because I played it a million times, but I'll play it a million more. I am so fucking pumped for that game. But yeah, maybe we'll make that a goal in the subathon. Maybe if we hit a certain amount of subs, I'll do a Johnny Bravo live stream. That'll be a thing. We'll see what happens. We'll see what happens as an incentive. I don't want any of this. I don't want to buy the Wario Emblem because that'll literally break my bank. Where are we at? We're at 2.5 hours. So I guess this is a good time to wrap things up, kind of. We got a lot of stuff done. We got two new partners in this past one. Got them both leveled up, grabbed a bunch of stuff, got a dirty sack, which now I can fill with 20 items. So that's pretty good too. I just heal myself, so that's pretty good as well. I guess I should just take some items out here. What the fuck is this? Oh. Oh. I need the Super Luigi book. I need it. Is it in my important things? Yes, you better fucking believe it is. Have you ever experienced a time when no matter how hard you tried, you failed, and the time you spent felt wasted? If you ever feel such pangs of regret, try to remember this tale, the story of a young man's quest to save a sweet princess. Super Luigi, Volume 1, The Quest Begins. The day dawned like any other day, but little did Luigi know that the letter when he was about to receive would forever change his destiny. Sir Luigi, danger besets us on all sides, and we beg your help. The foul Chestnut King has stolen our treasure, our fair princess. The letter was from Minister Crepe of the Waffle Kingdom. A man aware of Luigi's many adventures, he knew only Luigi could save them. Did it skip a page? Charged with this dire task, Luigi wasted no time curtailing the heroic meal he was making. Then he packed for his deadly journey. Knowing that his older, though less talented, brother was out on a no-doubt inconsequential errand, Luigi took a moment to leave a note. Mix a keel mango with a peachy peach to whip up a fruit parfait. Those cryptic words were all Luigi wrote before leaving. Upon reaching the Waffle Kingdom, Luigi was greeted by pure misery, an endless flow of tears over the kidnapping of Princess Eclair. We're gonna leave it there. Did I hear an ad stream? Ad stream can happen too. Maddie B is the Outcast cover, really. You can say words pretty fast, so that's a thing. I guess I'm gonna have to listen to it. We'll read more of Super Luigi later. I came in here to withdraw some items because I can now actually have some room in my my inventory for them. I'm gonna take out some super shrimps. Some of these super shrimps that I've been storing up. Maybe grab me a, no, not the jam and jelly. That is way too good for this. Same with the ultra shrimp. We'll grab the fresh juice. And I need an incoupon. And last but not least, I need some bouchette. Oh my god, dude. Luigi, yes. Thousand Year Door has so many little things. I mean, shit. Luigi's just chilling in this inn right now. Speaking of that, and you just hear like, hey, bro, I went to a Circuit Break Island and got a marvelous compass piece. You wouldn't believe it, bro. Do you want to hear?